Yo, it's your boy Andy Doe, teaching you supply and demand through a lyrical flow. Get buckled in, because we're getting ready to go. Supply and demand are important things. Not only do they make up the market, they're seen in every good and service you buy. They're even found in a car kit. Equilibrium is when they're equal. When a movie hits it, it's gotta get a sequel. First up, I'm gonna talk about demand. Basically, it's the number of things consumers want. Maybe you want a specific brand, or you had your eyes set on that brand new phone. Now, the demand is based off a couple of determinants. It changes, and these changes occur in swings. If demand rises, the curve will drop. If the demand falls, the curve will hop. What changes demand, you may be wondering? Well, let me speak, and soon I'll be thundering. One, you got the income of the consumer, how much they can spend. Two, also what they want, what's the style, what's the trend. Three, you got your populations, big ones want to spend. Four, price of related goods, whether it be those competing or the ones they be meeting. For example, if you got cereal, you want some milk. If you got cloth, you may want some silk. Finally, you got the future expectations. Maybe minimum wage rising in the nation, or an expected sale at your local gas station. Finally, there is a law of demand saying that when the price of goods is higher, the demand falls like it's on fire, because it's inverse. Yo, that's demand. Now we're talking about supply. The supply states that when the prices rise, the supply wants to get up real high. Supply involves producers, how much they make available, the goods and services that they make saleable. As with demand, there are still some determinants. Some, if changed, can cause quite some turbulence. The first determinant is the production cost. The more it costs, the greater the loss. This can include many different things: supply costs, wage rates, and taxes. Don't forget regulations made by the kings. Another is technology, quite a big deal. Improving it is definitely a huge deal. The number of producers creates competition. It helps efficiency become an addition. The last determinant is future expectation. If there's a price change, it changes the foundation. They'll keep their inventories or get rid of them. Hold on, let's not forget about graphing curves. For supply left and right, it will continue to swerve. For example, if the population starts to decline, then it will shift left. That's a bad sign. Thank you for witnessing my outstanding lesson. Remember Andy Doe, the one constantly impressive. Because the more you know is now what you show. Sorry, I'm out. It's time to go. Go watch some SpongeBob.